Hey there, you're tuning into episode 4 of the Managing Your Macros podcast, a quick and easy newbie-friendly guide to understanding your nutrition. I'm your host, John Dow, the Boston Architect. If you want to get in touch with me, hit me up on Twitter and Instagram with the handle AOABBU, like the Facebook page Architects of Aesthetics, or shoot us an email, aoabbu@gmail.com. I actually already had an episode 4 recorded, but this past week, I got a bunch of questions, so I want to stay on top of things, be as fresh as possible, let you guys know that I appreciate your listening, so I listen. The very first thing I want to hit, found out one of my clients was only drinking 16 ounces of water a day. Don't do that, please. Please drink a lot more water. 16 ounces, that's like half a can of Coke. Now again, if you're not used to drinking a lot of water, don't go off the deep end. You'll just burn yourself out. How about start drinking 2 more glasses of water a day? Super doable. So let's get to the topic at hand. This is for Fiddlin' Annie and also Mr. Ha Ha himself, Fillmore Ha. Both of them want to learn more about fasting. In the fitness community, you'll often hear people talk about intermittent fasting, IF. Now I want to give a quick plug right here. The best resource to learn about intermittent fasting is through Andy Morgan's website, rippedbody.com or athletebody.jp. Andy's great because while he's not the only person out there that's talking about fasting, he's definitely the easiest one to read and understand and comprehend. The bits that I know about intermittent fasting are through Andy Morgan. Super cool guy. Most of his information's out there for free. Definitely check it out. So to talk about fasting, let's start with breakfast, right? Because the words in breakfast itself, you're breaking the fast. A fast is the period of time that you go without eating. So if you finish dinner at 8 o'clock and you're not snacking, munching on anything, and you don't eat anything until the next day at 7 o'clock, 8 to 7, you carried over an 11 hour fast. Breakfast is breaking that fast. Let's be clear. Fasting shouldn't ever be about starving yourself, okay? It's delaying the calories that you would normally take in, pushing them off till later. So with intermittent fasting, most people, they opt out to skip breakfast because, you know, lunch and dinner, those are the more social meals, eating out, being with your family, that sort of thing. So if we use those same examples before, you finish dinner at 8 p.m., then now you're skipping breakfast. You're not going to have your lunch until 1 o'clock. Let me do my math real quick. 8 to 8, that's 12. It was 4, 12, 16, 17 hours. 17 hour fast, all right? Should have done it the other way, right? Anyway, you have a 17 hour fast and then a 7 hour eating window. So maybe you have 2 meals in that time. You stick with your typical lunch and dinner. You can even make one of those meals a significant meal, so a big lunch or a big dinner, or maybe you try to squeeze in the third meal in between. I do want to point out, fasting is not magic. You don't have to do fasting. The main reason why fasting can work for so many people is by eliminating a meal, you're already reducing calories by default. And don't forget the nutritional priorities. Number one, overall calorie intake. Number two, the macros. And then number three, the timing and frequency. Timing and frequency is not going to mean crap if all the calories that you're putting into your body is crap. But again, if you're reducing your amount of meals to 2 instead of 3, it's going to be hard to have an excess of calories that way, right? The reason why eliminating breakfast is so appealing to people. Imagine you're on the run. Trying to have time to eat breakfast can be really stressful. Sometimes you're not even hungry in the morning, but you have it ingrained in your mind that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. And what happens? That just adds more stress. Don't be stressed. If you don't have time for breakfast, if you don't want breakfast, that's fine. My friend Aaron Spagnolo, the premier wedding photographer in Boston, check his website, aaronspagnolo.net. He linked an article breaking down the problems with Kellogg's and breakfast foods. And yeah, if you didn't know, Dr. Kellogg really didn't have your best interests in mind when he was designing breakfast. Actually, he has a history of a bunch of sex-related stuff. Go watch Adam Ruins Everything for more information on that. If you do like breakfast, if you love breakfast, well, again, you don't have to do fasting. You don't have to cut it out. Let's take a look at the macros for a typical hearty breakfast. I mean, if I go to Denny's, what am I gonna get? What was it called? The Grand Slam? The Alabama Slammer? Anyway, you got eggs, bacon, sausage, and pancakes, right? So if we do two eggs, one egg in itself is 5 grams of fat, no carbs, 6 grams of protein. If we do bacon, one strip of bacon, 4 grams of fat, 0 grams of carbs, 8 grams of protein. Sausage links, one link, give or take 4 grams of fat, 0 grams of carbs, 6 grams of protein. And then pancakes, a stack of three, using the macros for Aunt Jemima, that's 7 grams of fat, 44 grams of carbs, 6 grams of protein. Let me get the calculator real quick. And this would be the part where I would whistle if I could. Woo! 33 grams of fat, 44 grams of carbs, 46 grams of protein. Now, if you recall my own personal set of macros, I'm about 50 grams of fat, 200 grams of carbs, 150 grams of protein. This fits well within my limits. But 33 out of 50 grams of fat, that might make it a little trickier to plan the meals later in the day. So if I didn't spend these numbers on my budget, if I completely remove out breakfast, I get a lot more flexibility with lunch and dinner. And that's why it can be so appealing for people to use intermittent fasting. If you do want to give intermittent fasting a shot, I would recommend easing into it. Don't go for a crazy fasting window right out the bat. Do something like a 16-hour fast, 8-hour feeding window. Do that for a couple weeks, then whittle down that feeding window. Maybe get yourself down to 6 hours of feeding time, 18 hours of fast. Slow, consistent progress. That's what you want right there. For whatever reason, I got spammed on Twitter. Some chick who is doing intermittent fasting, she lost 65 pounds in a year. According to her, zero workouts, just the fasting, zero adherence to macros. I'm not saying that she can't do that, but a little suspicious. And let me just use the spam bot as a case study. Is it possible to lose 50, 60 pounds in a year? Totally. But with whatever your fitness and nutrition goals are, you need to break down these different aspects. There's doable, realistic, and practical. So for this girl to lose 50, 60 pounds, only intermittent fasting, zero workouts, no adherence to macros. Doable, yes. Realistic, less so. Practical, I want to say no. And I want to use this as an illustration because for a lot of people who are in the thick of it, they're trying to get everything in order. They're surrounded by a lot of frustration. And then they see what looks like success for other people, and they start to question, why isn't that happening to me? Now listen, if you heard me on the show say, "Damn, why can't I be like Beyonce?" What would be your gut reaction? You would laugh, right? Doing what Beyonce does? Is it doable? Maybe. Realistic and practical? Less so, right? When you're wanting to lose weight, people see stuff on TV shows. They see rapid weight loss. They see those awesome before and after pictures. In just 1 month, in just 2 weeks. Listen, if you can lose 2 pounds in a month, that's ahead of schedule. 2 pounds in a month. More than that, way above schedule, okay? And again, that might not feel very satisfying. That might feel like it's too slow. But if you're working with that kind of progression, that's 2 pounds that you're definitely gonna keep off long term. You start shooting for a lot more. Again, totally doable. Focus on the realistic and practical. This happens to a lot of people, that yo-yo weight stuff. Think about people who lose weight for their weddings. They go balls to the wall. For chicks, I guess you wouldn't say balls to the wall, what would you say? Cooch through the roof. Yeah, they go cooch through the roof, lose this 20 pounds, feel miserable the whole time. After the wedding comes right back. They might have achieved the goal, but not in a sustainable way. All right? Sustainable is slow and boring. I wish there was another way. I wish it was more dynamic. Slow and boring. You think saving money's fun? No. One of the most slow and boring things that you can do. Right? But you know it's important. Oh, the last thing I was going to say about that chick on Twitter. So for the very fact that she didn't pay attention to her macros, she probably got the result of skinny fat. And this is the body composition where, yeah, you're slim, but you really have no muscle at all. And I'm not talking about bulky, I'm not talking about being cut, I'm just saying that your arms, your legs, your body just doesn't have anything there. You're still super unhealthy, even though you look thinner. Because remember, what's that one macros component that people usually don't get enough of in a day? That's right, their protein. Okay. Intermittent fasting can be way more in-depth, way more technical. But again, just a quick and easy sampling. You guys have questions or comments, be sure to check out the show notes that I'll release with this episode. You want to get in touch with me? Again, tweet or Instagram me, AOABBU. Email aoabbu@gmail.com. Too fast or not too fast? That is the question. I do not any longer. But maybe we'll talk about that next time.